Hi. In this second presentation, we will discuss how to represent the behavior of a finite state machine with data path. At the end, I expect that you will be able to explain how the ASMD block elements relate to the inputs and outputs of the FSMD control path, and also to explain the operation of the ASMD chart for the binary multiplier example. The presentation comprises two parts, starting with ASMD charts, followed by the binary multiplier example. Let's then start by considering how ASM charts can be expanded to represent the behavior of FSMDs. ASMD charts follow exactly the same rules of ASM charts, but handle register transfer level operations. This is the design level where FSMDs are mostly used, so ASMD charts become a very convenient representation mechanism for this type of circuits. You may recall that ASMD charts comprise ASM blocks, and that each ASM block represents one state and includes three types of elements: state boxes, only one in each ASM block, and optionally, but unlimited in number, decision boxes and conditional output boxes. Decision boxes comprise conditions based on inputs to the control path, while state boxes and conditional output boxes handle outputs of the control path. Moore outputs in the case of state boxes and Mealy outputs in the case of conditional output boxes. Having these concepts fresh in our minds, let's revisit the binary multiplier FSMD to see how they apply in practice. Binary multiplication offers an interesting example for an FSMD if we decide to perform it by adding one of the operands to itself as many times as indicated by the other operand. This algorithm requires a small number of data units comprising data registers, an adder, and one counter. These elements make up the data path architecture, and their operation will be coordinated by the finite state machine in the control path. This slide repeats the FSMD architecture that has been shown in the preceding presentation. Please notice the control path outputs and their role, and likewise the input coming from the counter to indicate that we have completed the multiplication process. The ASMD chart is fairly simple, as it frequently happens with FSMD architectures, since the control path is only responsible for the top-level operations. The initial state comprises two Moore statements, which take place unconditionally. The counter is loaded with one of the operands, and the adder register is cleared to reset the partial sum. Then in state S1, there are no Moore statements, and we need to take a decision according to the current value of the counter. If it is zero, the multiplication process is complete, and we need to update the output register with the content of the adder register. Otherwise, we still need to add the adder operand at least one more time, so the adder register is updated with the output of the adder block, and the counter is decremented to indicate that one more addition has just been made. Notice that there is a direct relation between each control path connection and the elements present in the ASM blocks. Each input to the control path corresponds to at least one decision box in the ASMD chart. In this case, there is only one input to the control path coming from the counter, and it corresponds to the decision box shown in state S1. Likewise, all outputs from the control path correspond to at least one state box or conditional output box in the ASMD chart. In this case, the outputs controlling the down counter operations correspond to the state box in state S0 and to the conditional output box at the bottom of state S1. This slide shows the generic technology model generated by Vivado Synthesis for this FSMD. It replicates the block diagram shown earlier, although the various blocks are not laid out in the same relative position. The simulation waveforms confirm operation as expected when the two operands are 4 and 6. Notice that the output value is represented in hexadecimal form, so 1/8 in hexadecimal is equal to 16 plus 8 in decimal. You may wish to download the VHDL files and to experiment in Vivado, namely by modifying the simulation source file and by including additional internal nodes in the simulation results. And this concludes the FSMD representation module. Thanks for your attention.